In this video, we will demonstrate how to do a recrystallization using the setup we built in the previous video on how to build a reflux setup. In this case, we're using quite a small flask for the amount of solid we're having for demonstration purposes. If you would do the same experiment in real life, I would strongly suggest using a bigger flask if you have this amount of solid. We're going to recrystallize blue copper sulfate using water. I have a rough estimation about how much solvent I will need, which is about 100 ml. If you do not have any idea how much solvent you will need, I would strongly suggest covering the solid you have with the solvent of choice and then start heating it until it's at reflux. If it doesn't dissolve, you can always add more liquid. It's harder to take liquid out while you're doing a recrystallization. So, for this recrystallization, I will add my solvent, in this case water, using one of the two side necks. So we're going to open it by removing the stopper. Now that the funnel is placed on our three-neck flask, I can roughly add 60 ml of water to this copper sulfate and start heating it and see if everything dissolves or not. When you're done adding your liquid, remove the funnel and place the stopper back into the three-neck flask. Now we'll have to heat our solid and our liquid by turning on the ECA hot plate, setting it to a temperature higher than the boiling point of your solvent. So in this case we're water, so we put it at above 100 degrees and rotate the lab jack up so it touches your flask. Turn the motor on so that it will stir, hopefully start stirring our stirring egg, and then we'll just wait until it starts boiling and everything starts dissolving. So it's been a while now, we've been heating our reaction mixture. We can see the condensation in the cooler, but when we lower our heating mantle, we can see that there's still precipitate or solids in the liquid. So we'll have to add more water to fully dissolve all the copper sulfate. So we'll add that now, then heat it up to reflux again, and hope everything dissolves. So the reaction has been standing for a bit more time, and now we can clearly see that everything has dissolved into this nice clear blue liquid. And to crystallize, we'll just have to let it cool down slowly to room temperature. So we stop the stirring, turn off the hot plate, and let it cool down. And as soon as it's fully cooled down to room temperature, the crystals, or when it's cooling down to room temperature, the crystals will form. And when it's at the room temperature, you can filter off the crystals, isolate them, and weigh them.